We have rectangle. Rectangle has four vertices, that is, it has four sides also. So a rectangle has line symmetry by those lines which are joining the midpoints of the opposite sides. Now these are just the diagonals you can see. What will be the lines that are joining midpoints of opposite side? We have the midpoint of AB as say P. We have the midpoint of DC as Q. We have the midpoint of AD as R and midpoint of BC as S. So if you want to make the line symmetry, that will be the line joining the midpoints of the opposite sides, that is RS and PQ. So RS line and line PQ represent the line symmetry, the two lines of symmetry for rectangle. What about the point symmetry? The point of intersection of diagonals. The point where the diagonals meet. Now the green ones are your diagonals. So what is the point where diagonals are meeting? This is the point. So that is the point of symmetry. And the rotational symmetry, that is how many times it can be rotated such that it gets back to its original state in one complete turn, that is two times. So we have the order of rectangle as two. Next is the kite. Kite has these sides equal, right? So what are the line symmetry for kites? The line symmetry for kite is the diagonals of the kite. The diagonal PR and diagonal SR represent the line symmetry for kite. What about the point symmetry and rotational symmetry? It does not exist in case of kite. We have the next as circle. Circle has a center, right? So how many line symmetries are possible for case of circle? We have infinite cases possible because there can be infinite lines passing through the center and they will be having symmetry about that line. The circle will have symmetry about that line. So we have infinite number of line symmetries possible for circle. We have center of the circle as the point symmetry, right? This is the point about which circle will be rotated. And how much is the rotational symmetry? We have the order as infinite. It can be rotated infinite times to come back to its original state.